it took way too long, but key officers at the Federal Reserve have eventually admitted that for months they mischaracterized an inflationary wave that has proven bigger and more insistent than they anticipated. That recognition is welcome, especially given the probability that inflation will remain uncomfortably high in the coming months. The question right now, not just for the Fed, but also more vastly for the United States and other major economies, is to navigate a policy terrain in which communication and enactment have been rendered significantly more complex by a fundamental misunderstanding of inflation as transitory. In today's video, we'll talk about the gold and silver movement after Powell's announcement. But before that, make sure you press that red subscribe button along with that tiny bell icon to get updated every time we post new videos. Let's get started. Fresh off the announcement that Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell will be kept on for a second term as the leader of the central bank, we've new comments from Powell pertaining to tapering and inflation. Powell admitted that the Fed was wrong in its forecasting of how long the current high inflation will last, and that they now believe it'll continue well into 2022. During a hearing before the Senate Banking Committee, Powell stated that when the Fed says transitory, they don't mean it as just referring to how long inflation will last, as the average person might anticipate. Still, he said it's time to stop using the word. So I think the word transitory has different meanings to different people, Powell told Senator Pat Toomey, Republican from Pennsylvania. To many, it carries a time, a sense of short-lived. We tend to use it to mean that it will not leave a permanent mark in the form of higher inflation. I think it's probably a good time to retire that word and try to explain more clearly what we mean. Powell claimed later on that the Fed won't sit inactively by and let inflation continue to climb indefinitely. We'll use our tools to make sure that higher inflation doesn't become entrenched, he said. In the Carter administration, the Fed jacked up interest rates as a means of battling inflation, which eventually worked. The economy is very strong and inflationary pressures are high, and thus it's appropriate to consider wrapping up the taper of our asset purchases, which we actually announced at the November meeting, maybe a few months sooner. But then again, Jerome Powell did not admit inflation is not transitory now. He admitted it back in September when he criticized inflation on supply backups that he could not forecast an end to. Despite their own accreditation, prices are not stable. However, they would be doing it already if they could do a thing about it. Occasionally, the simplest explanation is the right bone. While it hasn't done much to the downside in the months gold and silver has resisted multiple nerfs lower as a result of jawboning about tools to fight inflation. Again, tools that should have formerly been employed, but to this point haven't been. We believe the precious essence market has priced in interest rate hikes that are not coming. Looking at gold's relationship to long-term treasury yields listed for inflation, gold and silver are still holding up its end of the bargain fairly well. We don't believe yields are going to improve. In fact, quite the contrary. We believe what will really be temporary is any potential tapering of bond buying. So that's all for today's video. Let us know your views in the comments section below. And don't forget to like this video before leaving. Thanks for watching.